Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zyborn Stellar, and today I'll be doing a commentary for this gameplay video that I did a few hours ago. And right off the bat, I don't even know what in the world happened there. I got knocked off to the side there, I almost crashed into the tree, but thankfully no one was hurt, so it's all okay. But like I was saying, I'll be doing a commentary for this gameplay video, as well as talk about the most recent Battlefield 3 news. In addition, to also have a small giveaway for a Dr. Pepper code. So let's get down to the news stories. So the first news story says, or the headline says, DICE to make expansions, not map packs, and more on BF3 balance. So the news story says, in a podcast with the official PlayStation blog, community manager Ian Tornay, aka Crash7800, it just lost where I was. Spoke a few words about DICE's upcoming expansion pack to Battlefield 3, Back to Garkin. Here, he really stressed the words expansion pack. We're interested in not doing map packs. We want to make expansions. We want to add content. And we want to change the way people are playing. End quote. Whether or not this was a hint at other franchises with heavy duty post launch support, this is definitely a unique take on adding content to a big hit title with long-lasting value. If we can take Battlefield Bad Company 2's Vietnam as any indication, we can expect good things from Battlefield 3 or from DICE in the future. Quote, with Frostbite wow, that was bad. With Frostbite 2 being a new engine and Battlefield 3 being our biggest launch ever and the best Battlefield ever, we're so focused on getting user feedback. We really want Battlefield to be long tail, to be for the users, by the users. That's kind of cool. And I guess real quick, guys, if my voice is a little weird or I can't really talk right now, that's because I just did like 5 commentaries, so this will be my 5th one today, so sorry about my inability to talk right now correctly, so that's why I just kind of messed up there for a second, so I apologize for that. But let's get back to the news story. So, like I said, it's going to be a game by the users, so, or to the users, for the users, by the users, something like that. So, mention Tornay. What we want, or what we can most likely take from this is that if you have any strong ideas for post-launch downloadable content, let DICE know. As Tornay said, quote, we're not ruling anything out, end quote. Alan Kertz also recently spoke more on the subject of balance in his continuing search for fan feedback. Some fans noticed this, or his intent to increase the general damage of semi-automatic sniper rifles, assault rifles, and light machine guns over long range. Kertz clarified, saying, quote, slightly, so that it's 5 hits at range, even if you hit limbs, end quote. Speaking of range, some have noticed that the range of the recon class weapons aren't as long as what many think it should be. Kurt's response, quote, all bullets had a standard time to live. The sniper rounds will be getting an increase in the future. Yay for that! Lastly, Kurt has stated the final word on more than 24 players on consoles. Quote, not this generation. So, sorry guys out there that were still, you know, hanging out to the, hanging on to the hope that maybe you would get maybe 32 players for consoles, but I guess Mr. Kurtz here just shut down your hopes. So 24 players it is, at least for this generation anyway. So blame the 360 and PS3 for being all hardware, so I guess that's that. But anyway, moving on to the next and very long news story, and I think it's the final one too. It says Battlefield 3 2 gig PC patch on December 6th, patch notes, and this is going to be very long, so let's dive headfirst into this thing. So a new sizable patch in the works for Battlefield 3. DICE's Michael Combs has announced a new patch for the PC version of Battlefield 3. The new patch will go live on Tuesday, December 6th, and I think that's the day when Back to Karkin is released on PS3, so coincidence? Probably not. At 8 a.m. Greenwich something time. I think it's Meridian. Greenwich Meridian time. So, you know, if you live in Europe, at 8 a.m. It's both client and server side. The patch will set you back a whopping 2 gigs in memory, as it contains a large portion of Bactricorkin assets, which is interesting. It's worth noting that both players and RSPs, whatever that is, will have to update in order for the game to run properly. So, 2 gigs, whatever. That shouldn't take more than, say, 30 minutes for me. So, here are the patch notes. So, the first one, or the first long-ass list. So, bugs. Bug fixes. Fix a problem with, or number one. Fix a problem with spawn timer now showing blue border on startup and lost spawn point. Number two. Fix a problem where players who join queuing on end of round got the spawn screen stuck on screen, but unable to do anything with it until next round loaded. Number three, fix a problem where camera would change to third person on kill cam when kill cam was turned off in server settings. Number four, fix the stat references on several dog tags. Number five, fix for surveillance ribbon not counting TUGS, which is the motion sensor. Number 6. Fix a missing combat area lines on the minimap for Grand Bazaar Conquest Small. Number 7, I think? Move a tank spawning US base on Kessian border so it would not be destroyed by a falling tree. What? Falling tree? Destroying tanks now? What the hell? Okay. Number 8, fix a problem where placing C4 with the Russian soldiers was playing US faction VO. Oh, the voiceover. Number 9, fix a problem where TB guided missiles could be shot into its own helicopter and destroy it. What the hell? Really? I never knew that could happen. Then again, I don't have the TB missile thingy, so. Number 10, I think? I really lost count. Fix a problem when attempting to fire lock-on weapons without a target. Number 11. Tweak the chat. It should now be a bit easier to read. Okay, how about just make it transparent? That'd be great. Number 12. Fix several vehicles that did not properly shoot rockets and guns towards their predictive sites. Number 13. Fix the G17 suppressed laser not working properly. Number 13. Added alternate HUD colors to help color blinds. Oh, that's nice of them. Number 14, added a network interpolation settings. This allows users with good bandwidth, reduced latency, but might increase some stuttering. The user can find what works best for his connection by tweaking the slider. Oh, that sounds interesting. Number 15, I believe, increase the spawn protection radius on Team Deathmatch. Number 16, fix a problem with smoke on land vehicles. Missiles should now miss more often. Number 17, fix a problem where users could end up with IRNV scope in any vehicle. I think that was a glitch that people use. Good that they are fixing that. Number 18, fix a problem where a player dies if vaulting over a ledge into water. And sorry guys, VLC there. Kind of messed up my commentary, so I apologize for that. I think it crashed or something, so instead of starting over, I decided to just save that portion of the commentary, and I'll just pick up where I left off. So I guess I was talking about the upcoming Battlefield 3 patch for PC, and I was talking about the patch notes, and I believe I was on number 18 or something. So for the one that I was talking about was it said fix a problem where players dies if vaulting over a ledge and into water while sprinting. The next one says fix several crashes and increase general stability. The next one is fix a problem where the user was unable to revive two players that have the bodies one over the other. The next one says fix so you can have a so you can assign an axis and use as a digital input. This makes it possible for the player on PC to assign one of the sticks on a gamepad to be used for throttle or brake. Fix a problem with the kill camera acting up when suiciding from parachute. Next one, fix air radar was showing too much, now laser tagged heat signature above threshold enemy missiles and capture points are only visible on air radar. Okay, that's interesting. Fix a problem where the game would enter a technical hang if the user press pause menu and tilt at the same time. Fix a problem where you could get green flashes on screen. Next one, you can now reassign psycho weapons. Next, fix so the weapon zooms automatically after bipod deploys is gone when using zoom toggle. And the final one says that fix a problem where the parachute would stay stuck in the air if the owner was killed. And moving on to the final list, which is balance tweaks. So number one, fix several weapons so they are properly suppressed and hide the player on the minimap when fired. The number two, tweaked tactical light so it is not as blinding over longer ranges. Number three, tweak the IR&V scope so it is limited to usage only at close range. Number four, reduce heat masking effectiveness of Spec Ops camo. Reduce heat masking effectiveness. Okay, I didn't even know it had any effectiveness. I just used it because it was the best camo that looked the coolest. So I guess so much for using that again. So I'll still use it, but I didn't even know it had any effectiveness over the IR&D. So, but anyway, moving on. The next one, number five, I think. Fix a bug where ammo spec would give additional 40mm grenades instead of frag spec. Number six, increase the number of additional 40mm grenades from frag spec. Number seventh, fix so AT mines only live for 20 seconds after a player dies to prevent infinite mines. We want to make a difference fix in the future. It's in Jira, which I'm not sure what that stands for. Just in something something. Anyway, the next one says increase the time to live on sniper caliber rounds to allow extreme distance shots, which I would definitely like that. Next one says fix several weapon descriptions, calibers, and fire rates. The weapons themselves have not changed. Next one, fix so the M9 and MP443 pistol can be equipped by the opposing faction where it is unlocked at 100 kills. And I guess that's the main reason why I always have to switch before the game starts. Like when I'm rushing, I usually have the, I think the MP443 pistol as default. And you know, that's the pistol that I want to use. But when it changes to the US side, I always start out with the M9 pistol, which kind of annoys me because I want to use the MP443 always, so I have to change back to the MP443 for the M9. So hopefully it'll stay, you know, that way every time I start playing a match. You know, hopefully it won't change to the M9 when I'm playing as the US forces. So, but anyway, where was I? Okay, here we go. Fixed laser-guided missiles missing their targets if the target is moving too fast. Next one, reduce the effectiveness of stealth on air vehicles. The next one says reduce the effectiveness of beam scanning for jets. A lot of reducing. Next one, reduce the damage done to armor vehicles and infantry from AA guns. Oh, that's good. Those AA weapons were just a little too damaging against, or you know, too effective against tanks and such. The next one says slightly decrease the accuracy for all weapons on fully automatic. Burst fire is now preferable at mid to long range. Okay, I guess that's good. Next one says increase the effective accuracy of long bursts for LMGs when using a bipod. Oh, that is good, because the bipod will sometimes not be that good when using it on an LMG. So the next one says slightly increase the range of the 44 Magnum bullets. That's interesting. Use it as a sniper rifle. Next one says increase the close range damage of 4.6 times 30mm and 5.7 times 28mm bullets. Next one, increase the reload time of the mortar from 3.5 seconds to 4.8 seconds. So it's not going to be as much. And it says, and reduce the aim accuracy bonus given by a suppressor for the MP7. Oh, wait, that's not it. And increase the time it takes before a shell hits the ground. So, alright, that's good. Reducing the effectiveness of a mortar, that's good. And the next one, I think I already said it by accident, has reduced the aim accuracy bonus given by a suppressor for the MP7, P90, PP2000, PP19, and UMP45. PP19, that's not even out yet. The next one says increase the range and FOV for designating targets with the SOFLAM and laser or vehicle laser designators, like the CITV stationed on a tank, or the laser designator on a scout, or you know, or any helicopter, I think. Next one says decrease the effectiveness of 12G frag ammo when equipped on semi-automatic and automatic shotguns. Next one says slightly decreased the power of fighter jet cannons against all vehicles targets, especially helicopters. What? Are you serious? The jet cannon is being... Wait, I read that wrong. Increase. Oh, Jesus. I was about to be really mad because it said... I thought it said decrease. I was like, crap. No, don't make it more worse than it already is. But thank God that they're increasing it instead. So, yay for that. It's not going to be able a little bit easier to destroy tanks with the cannon instead of just kind of do a bit of damage like it does right now. So, that's good. Anyway... Next one says decrease the power of miniguns against jets and helicopters. Decrease the power of miniguns? Like what? Like the labs? Or, you know, the AA, the mobile AA, I guess? Is that what they're talking about? I hope so. Because AA mobiles are pretty annoying. But then again, I use the jets a whole lot, so people out there might disagree with me. But anyway. Moving on to the next one, it says increase the power of stingers against jets. Oh no! Anyway, next one says flares reload times for jets and helicopter gunners have been increased. Aw, crap. Well, I guess it's good, but 10 seconds was long enough, not what it's gonna be like. Doesn't even say. Come on, give me a specific time so I can be like 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, come on, hurry up for the flares to come up. Oh man. Anyway. Moving on to the next one, tweak the AA-94 so its burst fire better conveys the real-world advantage offered by this weapon, which, by the way, I think I unlocked that weapon in this gameplay video, actually, so I'll get to use it tomorrow. The next one says, slightly increase the recoil of on the M416 and removed burst fire. Okay, burst fire mode. This weapon incorrectly had burst fire, which was not authentic. I didn't know that. Okay, I guess it's just gonna be just full auto and single shot like the N416, so, or like the M416, like the M6A3. So, I guess what's gonna be the difference between the M16A3 and the M416 now? Not a whole lot. So, oh well. Anyway. Moving on to the next one, which says tweaked the spawns for TDM on Cargo Island, Grand Bazaar, Caspian Border, Zinc Crossing, Operation Firestorm, Devon Peak, and Nashor Canals. Pretty much all the maps except for one. Let's see, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, which is missing? I'm not sure which map is missing, but whatever. Pretty much all the maps except for like 2. Anyway, moving on to the next one. Move a tank spawning US base on Caspian Border so it will not be... What? Same one, I already read that. What the hell? Next one. Tweak the gas station capture area and conquest on Caspian Border. Okay, just tweak. What do you mean by tweak? Be more specific, damn it. The next one says tweak the max vehicle's height on Nashor Canals. Vehicle height. So, did they finally fix the ceiling on Nashor Canals? Because flying a jet in that map is sort of really annoying because you get stalled like flying like 200 meters. So, yeah, not the best map for a jet, that's for certain. But anyway, I think that was the final one after like a long time of me reading all these damn tweaks, which hopefully will be great on December 6th when the patch finally comes. So. And again, once again, you know, I apologize for the thing with VLC messing up my commentary. Once again, this is me picking up. This is basically part two of the commentary for this gameplay video, so sorry about that. Once again, you know, VLC, why the hell did you screw me? But anyway, I guess this is the part where I get down to the giveaway for a Dr. Pepper code. So today's question, very similar to the previous ones, is let's see, which was your favorite primary assault class weapon? So of course the first one, you know, the first two weapons you can choose from are the AK-74M and the M16A3. So between those two, which one did you like the best at the beginning, you know, as you were making your way up towards ranking up and using those two weapons? The beginning, and right there I was trying to knife the fucking fence and I kind of fucked up. So that's why I threw an A by accident. But once again, the question is, which was your favorite starting assault class weapon, the AK-74M or the M16A3? Leave your answer in the comment section and I'll choose a winner tomorrow. And today's winner was Mr. Curry Were 5 TMIT Mayo. Sorry if that's not how I was supposed to say your name, but you're the winner for today's, or yesterday's, I guess, giveaway. So be sure to keep an eye out, or, well, I already sent you the message, so just go to your private messages and look for my message and say, yes, I want the code, and yes, I have BF3, please give me the code, and I'll send it to you right away. So, I guess that's that, and I still got a few more minutes to go as far as this gameplay goes. So, and I'm not sure if the gameplay is gonna be synced with what I'm saying right now, so I might be slightly off by like a few seconds, because once again, you know, like I said, VLC kind of crashed, so I kind of had to start the not the recording over, but pick up where I left off, kind of sort of where I left off. So, but I guess I should have said this at the beginning. I'm using the F2000 with the infrared scope, using it, you know, while still awesome, with the foregrip and I think the laser sight. And just like it was in the beta, it's such a great weapon. I mean, definitely the best assault rifle. Although I do like the AEK-971 too. I've been seeing a lot of people using that weapon, and it's just a really good gun too. So, but I like the F2000 slightly more. But anyway, like I said, tomorrow I'll be using the AN-94, checking that weapon out. I played a bit with it in the beta, but not my favorite for certain. But maybe this time around it'll change my mind. Maybe it is a good weapon for once, and we'll see. But anyway, I guess that's that. And today, by the way, I did a different type of a guide for the Modern Game Studio channel. I'll be doing a guide that's going to be specific, or guides that are going to be specific to a weapon rather than just, you know, a class or a type of vehicle. So today's guide was about the M16A3, and I'll be uploading it today, so hopefully by tomorrow it'll be, you know, ready to go. So you can check out the Modern Game Studio channel for that guide. It's really quick, it's around 4 minutes long, so it's not very long. So, you know, if you want to know more tips for the M16A3, check out my guide. It's just, like I said, really quick, pretty much just me going over the weapon specs and what attachments you should use with it, and you know, what type of fire rate you should use at, you know, what range and stuff like that. So I guess I'll just stop talking about it, otherwise I'll just flat out say what I talked about. So, but anyway, I guess you guys should check out that guide that I made. Like I said, it's really short. So anyway, I guess that's that, and I think we were close to winning, then we kind of messed it up. So, you know, Battlefield, when you think you're going to win, thinks my turn for the worse, as it were. So, just because you're like 100 tickets up in the leaderboard, or, you know, in the game, I guess, doesn't mean you're going to win. It's not secure until you're like double tickets, maybe. That's even the time when you should be celebrating your victory early. But right there, for a second there, we thought, oh my god, we might actually pull a clutch, but no cigar. and I probably shouldn't have said that, but we got really close. You know, it was still on 4 tickets. Still, I don't even know how or why, but it was still counting down, trying to get more kills for, you know, to win, but we couldn't quite do it. So, but anyway, guys, I think the video ended right there. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and once again, I apologize for VLC fucking my thing up. So, but anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, don't forget to comment in the video, maybe about the giveaway for the Dr. Pepper code. Also, don't forget to rate the video, hopefully a thumbs up, and you know, don't forget to leave feedback on the video as well. If you know some things that I did wrong, some things that I did right, what you like, what you don't like, stuff like that. So, and don't forget to actually subscribe to my channel so you can keep up with all the videos that I've been making. I've been making a lot of videos today, so 5 damn commentaries, that takes a long time. So, but anyway, guys, I hope you liked the video. Like I said, so I guess I will see you guys later. Bye.